Let's open up the mic. Good morning. It's November 18, 2019. Another episode of Office Development. Today I'm looking at the document events. And let's start the show. Welcome back. It's Monday morning. Not quite awake yet. Hi David, good morning. How are you today? It's, let's see, 21:46 in PST, Pacific. 12:46 Eastern. And it's 6:46 in Europe, where I am. Today I'm going to look some more at document events in Office Development, Office JavaScript. And let's show the code. Also, a shout out to Kito Kaboo. For following. I added, by the way, a point system to my stream, so you should see some loyalty points. If you hang out long enough, then you get loyalty points. So hang in there. Also some other points if you go to bang commands. You can go to the commands page and then you see all the commands available, like points. I think I have 0 points. Well, I don't give myself points, but if you, for instance, follow me, then you get 25 points already. I tried to add in everyone who already is following me, but not everyone was online. So if you're missing your follow points, just ping me and I try to add them. Let's kick in WinWord. Last week, Friday, we stopped at the point where we created some add-ins. What is this? Is that the one of the add-ins? Kicking the debugger. Let's see what is bringing us to here. Welcome, good morning, or good afternoon, depending where you are. You can always, at any time, you can type in project. That will give me a description of what I'm currently doing, trying to do. Do resize. What is the origin of this? Microsoft Office ASB. Google. Maybe I have a virus on my system. MSO. What was it saying? ASB. MSO ASB. File download and fix for Windows OS. Looks scary to me. risk analysis. I have no idea where this is kicked in. Close this. Don't save. Check the run options in here. Where are the options? I miss several things in here. This is strange. There they are. Trust center. Trusted locations. There's nothing in here. See users. Live coder. App data. Roaming, Microsoft Word, no, Microsoft Word, startup, nothing in here, so I think it's a glitch of Word. But I've seen it just before the stream as well. It's not gone. They want to debug? No. Come on. Good start of the week. Do resize. Not sure what it's trying to resize. Script lab. Need to figure it out what is causing this. How are you all doing in the chat room? Where from? What are you doing? Let's see, what did we do in here? Create content controls. Content control by ID. This was the thing that we did last time. Trying to do, because while I was looking at this content control edit event, my guess is that's not ready kicked in yet for the reason that this is a beta library. So let's try to open this one. Scan for the event in there. Copy. See, it's not found. So the preview documentation is not right. And I kind of depending on this. For my project. Content control edit. control delete it. Let's lower the music a little bit. Content control deleted. Let's see if there's a content control deleted. It's not. There's no content control at all. So, where are all these items going? Let me look at the original one. That's the same. ES6. Host type. I'm on host type word. Well, let's try some regular common events first. Google Office Dev Events Office JS JavaScript and add some word in here. Documents JavaScript API. This is the one that we looked at last week. Add handler async. Oh, I was trying to search for this. It's not in here. Because if I go to, let's open another instance, WinWord, and have a look at VBA F12, if I'm correct, no. Shift F11, no, come on. Alt F11, it's been such a long time ago. And click F2 on here. Then you see all the events. Let's go to the document. Document object. And sort. Group members. Yeah. Then you should see the events on the end. Like the open event. Here's the content control after add. Let's check, for instance, the open event. Where's the event handler thing, like this. This is the one, triggers. the selection change. So if I'm going over here, random, type in some text. And where is the subscribe to event 2? In here, create content controls, trigger the handler. So if we run this, if I clicked on the create content control part, run in this pane. That case, you see that I turn these items into content controls, each of the paragraphs. Why did I underline this? Create content controls, and this also triggers the selection change, if I'm correct. Let's select something else. Content control added. Why is it saying content control added? Apparently it's triggering something else. Good morning, by the way. Or good afternoon, depending where you are. If you have questions, just ask me in the chat room what I'm working on. Bang project. Type in project, the Bang project. You can get in the description of what I'm working on. Also, check your points. Bang points, I think. Points. Yeah, 0 points for me. I was checking why there is a content control added in here. Back to the code. I also wonder why my messages are not kicking in. Are they? Go to my dashboard. Let's have a look at my timers. Should be active. Oh, after 20 minutes. Yeah. We're not in yet 20 minutes, I think. No. Let's check back a little later. It said add content controls. Wait, did it say add content control? This one. Oh, wait, yeah. I'm triggering the other handler. That's incorrect. I triggered the content control added event while I should be triggering the select event. Let's run this again. Delete all of this. Put in some text. Delete the last paragraph. Create content controls. And a selection event just happened. If I move my selection again to a different location, it changed the selection. Right. So if you compare that to this one, let's move back to the code on the Word document. And see where we added the handler on the Word document. It was added here. And what did we add? Selection changed. In VBA, there should be a selection event, a selection object. Selection. Let's see if there's an event on this. There's no event on this. This is not a selection changed. So I might wonder if this is a new event. This is the one, this window selection change. That's on application. XML selection change is also on application. So apparently they moved the selection event from application to document. Because if I go to the document object, over here, go to the bottom of the list, building block insert, XML after insert. So what's the sync event doing then? Well, let's first start with the simple ones, with the open, new or closed event. Let's see if that's still in there. Where's the word instance? Let's close one. What type of events do we have? According to this one. You see the content control added event is not recognized at all. Even though the documentation says it's there. So I might need to ping Juan Balmori, what's his name, from Microsoft about this. Office, GitHub, API extractor inputs Word. This is a GitHub pool. Dev machine beta build generated November 17, 2017. That's exactly yesterday, 2 years ago, from Tenet Excel API. Version 1688.16. What are we on in the current version? If you have questions, thanks for following by the way. Just ask your questions in the chat room. Try to answer them. What what was I going to do? Look at the version. Oh, that's already the December version. I'm on the Office Insider version. Wow, come on. Back to the document. Let's see what it's saying about the content control event. Difference. Find it. 0. So why did it surface the result then? Did it change it? Did I move it out? Was this one we already looked at? The annotation changed. So why is this only this limited set event type? Because these are not the only events available. Let's see what the autocomplete will bring us. Office event type. Node inserted. Yeah, this is obviously all global, so also I think including something like Outlook, and it's doing the document selection changed. Let's try to find this one. There's much more in here. Selection changed. Resource selection changes. Project. Okay. This one is still Word. Active view changed, attachments changed. Document selection changed. Triggers when a document level selection happens. Yeah, that's the one that we had over here. There's not much in here. Custom XML node is deleted. Okay. Node is inserted. We have been looking at the node insertion. Gist. Custom XML parts. So if I just copy this part, put it in Notepad for now. Notepad, my preferred editor. Well, not really, but it's my buffer. And then close this, try to open custom XML part examples. Is that the one? Yeah. So in this case, I add a node in here. So I wonder if I put in such a thing as an event handler. Node inserted. Node inserted. I only have one handler in here, so let's clean up the code a little bit. There's a typo. This one is the first one with options, and the other one, I think the one is a little bit smaller. This one without callback. It's option 2, yeah. So let's put it in the simple one. No. Subscribe to event. Column up. Run this. Let's see if we can get some event triggered if we add a node in there. Is that the node? Yeah, node inserted. Run. The document is just text. No, not really. That depends. You can query the text of the document, like the selection, but you can also can query the XML from the document, and then you get the formatted objects back. Let's do the no callback item. Invalid parameters. That's interesting. And why is that? Where's my other Word document in here? Copy, put that in Notepad just for reference. Close the app, add in. Let's see, Office, Context, Document, Text. This is an interesting question, by the way. If I go to the official basic, do we have it still open? Yeah. There's a document. And what you do is get a range for this, like content. Content. Let's see, what's the property of this? Yeah, content. That's a range. So if you look at the code here. Oh. Document. Content. There's no content in here. So apparently they did it different. Selection. That's an interesting question, because how do you get the selected, how do you get the text from the document in JavaScript? Oh, that's the wrong Google. Get document content JavaScript Office JS. Like this. As a manifest, here they are creating the complete document. Add JavaScript to get the document. Get file async. Get slice. Slice object gives you the access to the data contained in the file. Wow, this is complex. And then you read it from my code and my encode base. Get the whole document from an add-in. You can create an Office add-in that provide a one-click sending or publishing a Word to a remote location, but that's not what I want. I just want to edit the selection. Read or write data to the active selection. Get selected data async. Following example, how to get a data from a selection in a document by using get selected data async. And by doing this, you get the plain text, I think. And then I agree with David, mentioning that it's just text. Even though, if you go to the VBA or the Visto add-ins, you can take out much more than that. Stop detecting. Remove handler. Okay. That's also interesting to know. Document selection changed. Yeah, that was the one that I had in my, this one as well. So it says remove handler async, then the event in place, I would expect this to be an enum as well, so maybe the documentation is not right. And my handler, that's this one. This is a named argument, I think. And the function is the result, getting back the result. Let's look for an example of this. Read and write data to the active selection. Get selected data async, that's getting the selection. So if there's nothing selected, then so let's take this out, copy and bring this over here. It's keeping me on top. So don't take the inserted, but take the other one. Document selection changed. And this was selection changed. And in case the selection changed, I'm going to show what is in there. This. Office content document get selection data async text and then async result. If async result is something, it's failed. If then it's going to write. And I think I already have a write in here somewhere. Yeah, like this. Can take that out. So let's do this. Subscribe to event that's handled here in without callback. Run it. Run this pane. Run without callback. Done. So now I change my selection and select something. Selection changed. Why does it say check? Check, and you see that the selection data, themes and styles. When you click design and choose a new theme, the pictures, charts, and smarter, blah blah. Okay. So what I'd like to do is extract this information from the code, because this is a nice example showing events. Copy all, copy, because I can do this, like rename this, play with events, playing around with Office JS events. I guess the document is text and the code itself is in the ScriptLab extension window. That's true. because the script lab item is just an add-in, and it's looking at the context of the Word document. Like update it, and let's share this as a new public gist. Let's see if I now got a new one. Yes. And now I need to clean this up quite a lot because I don't need all the content control items in there. So let's take this one out and this one out. And then take this one out. So we only leave the one in that we are using for the events. So also should keep the right item. This one. Let's move that to the end. Try catches maybe still used. It is, yeah. Result handler, that's used, but not in the without callback. Well, let's leave that in anyway. Show XML part. Delete. Delete. All cleaning up for this specific example. With callback, that can be deleted as well. So now we have only one remaining. XML part without callback, and then we can clean up the buttons in here, like this one and all the other ones. Then let's check what we've left for this, just the event. Run this. I got just last Friday, as you suggested. I am able to follow now. Thanks for the tip. Yeah. Would be nice if I can add an command in here, like go to stream elements, where is it, my dashboard, and I put a command in here, chat command. Create a custom command, add a new command, make that gist. You can find my gists on GitHub at, let me check, gists are. Reference of my live stream demos. Activate command. So now you should be able to do bang gist. This will give you the link for my gists. Let's check, and indeed, so thanks for the suggestion. So now everyone can simply type in gist. Can also make this an alias, I think. If you don't know if it gist or gists should now also work as well. Keywords are alternate ways to trigger command. You can be anywhere in the message and do not need exclamation mark. Okay. So if I type in gist and save this, if I now go to my stream and I type something in like where are your gists, then it's not working because I added gists. Let's see if that's working. Save it. Where are your gists? Yeah, there you are. What gist is this? The single gist is not working. Why is that not working then? It's in my command. Not sure. Maybe there's a timeout on it, cool down. Well, leave this as is and let's see how it's evolving. And now it's saying two, even though there's only one button. Put in the text again. Oh, I don't need to put any text in because it's not doing anything. Oh, yeah, I was going to test the selection. First, edit the button text. Button text in here. Test events. Heading selection event. Make a selection, then test events, creating the custom XML part in the back, and now I'm changing my event selection and select something. Now you see theme until headings. This is the text that I selected. But I also would like to be able to just select the complete document text, and not by doing this, changing my selection, but just interacting with the document. Google get document content office JS. Writing office add-in, the default add-in function, get text, select the document, try to modify the function to get the full text of the document, and the answer of this is, and who answered this? Yeah, Juan Balmori, that's the PM of Microsoft. And what he is showing here is, if you use the word-specific API for this, your code would be much simplified. Oh, this is the body. Yes, that's the one that I was looking for. Right, that's much easier. But apparently the body is you're loading the body item in here, then you sync it, so you collect it from the document, and from the body then here's your answer, David. You're getting either text, but my guess is that you can pick someone else as well, not only the text. Let's try this. Copy, go to Word, then go back to the code. Then add a new button in here. Let's put this in here for let's do it not in here but in my buffer. Like that. Create a new button over here. Copy. Make that number 2. Get document text. And change the name. ID get document text. Copy that again for the buffer in here. Move to the script, create a new function button handler that should take this one in. If it's clicked, then the get document button is the one. Then add another function, async function. Function with a C. Get document text. I'm already getting more experience in the JavaScript stuff. Copy. This is the one from the example by Juan Balmori. And instead of console, I'm going to write this out to the this one. So make this a write then. Write. So after the sync, The function write will be triggered and pushing out the document body text. Let's see how this is going. So by now I'm not adding an event, but just going to show the text of this in here. Run this. Get document text. I have no selection at all. I should change the link in here as well. Get document text. I also need to change the header apparently. Didn't write out anything. I think I didn't change something because it's performing the other one. I didn't change over the I didn't change over the handler. Get document text. So what I'm now doing, if you click the get document text button, it kicks in the function get document text, runs the word thingy with the context in there, loads the context, the body of the document, and writes it out to the add-in. Run. Doesn't look like my events are running. For some reason. And that's the events related to my stream, like see timer like this, follow chat lines. I do have more than 10 chat lines, I should think. Yeah, but maybe chat lines are too low, not enough comments from everyone. So feel free to jump in on the chat window if you have questions or want to just say something about what you're doing, what you're working on, or what else. Let's also check the leaderboard. Ah, David is on top, 55 points. You get 5 points for each 10 minutes that you are in the chat. So if you go to leaderboard, bang, leaderboard. That should give something back. It's showing, the leaderboard like this. You can check your own point level. Even if your points are high enough, you can basically earn some privileges in the chat window. And eventually you may be upgraded to moderator for the stream. But then we need to build some trust here. How long have you been working in computers? Yeah. If you go to about me, there's AAFVSTAM. That's my about me, and it's saying that I'm already started in the 80s, so I'm that old, yes. And that's going back to your questions, it's 80s, 19, 20s, 2010, 2020, at the end of the month, next month, we're 2020, so about 40 years already. How crazy is that? getting way too old. Working as a software engineer over 30 years. Yeah, Jay's it now to 35 maybe. And I'm currently a lead developer. Not doing that much coding anymore. For that reason, I started this live stream to keep the code, my code skills a little bit up and running. Especially because I've been doing a lot of coding in the office space, like the Microsoft office space, not the office building space. But I was developing using C# and Visual Studio tools for Office. But I obviously started back in the 80s with Visual Basic for applications, building some small macros, and eventually moved into C# and doing much more advanced applications. But now I'm a dev lead. I don't build that much applications anymore. So what I'm planning to do is to rebuild one of my Office add-ins. That's from Visual Studio Tools for Office. And do that makeover, rebuild it in JavaScript. Drifting off, let's change the header of the document here. Like test interacting with the document and get some events going. And the link to this is also somewhat different. Here are the add-ins. No, that's not the one that I was looking for. Office JS events. Word. Oh, come on, typo. It's early Monday for me. It's almost time to wrap up, by the way, because as said, I have my day job going on. So I have to prepare that. At around 8, is about 7 minutes from now, then I'm leaving the stream and be back tomorrow, same time, 6:45 Europe time. That's 9 hours ahead of Pacific. 6 hours ahead of Eastern. I was looking for the events, but where are the events? API reference. Is there something about events in here? Here, by the way, is the body. Body is on the context. Document body. Did we collect a document body in the code here as well? Yeah, that's right. Q command, load body, font size, font name. Synchronize the document state by executing the Q command. Sync font. Yeah, so this is also an interesting example. Let's put that in as well. So instead of just loading the body, also load font size, font name, font color and style. Copy. So what you do in here is you define what parts of the object model you want to load from the context. So instead of just loading the body in here, I'm now also loading the font size, font name, font color, and the style. And then context sync. Collect the items in here, make that a text. There's a sync in here. And why is body not recognized? Yeah, because that's not body, but it's document body. So taking the font size, font name, font color, and font style from the body object, and then not only display the body content, but also write out the results. Let's check. Run. No, I said run. Run in this pane. Let's clean this part up so we don't have that much text in the output. Get document text. And there's an error. Property text is not available. Before reading the properties value, call the load method. And I did do that, wasn't it? Oh, wait. Let's see. The text. I moved this one out. So interesting, because I did not have the text in the previous one. So let's copy this and put it aside. Copy. Because the old one is also in here, I think. So in this case, I did not need to, and for the reason I did not specify any of the properties. So what happens if I leave this out completely? Does it load everything? Or is this done specifically for the font? Let's run this. Let's see, get document text. And it's completing the size not available. Yeah, because now I don't have the font. So for this reason, you have to specify the load of the font, but not only the load of the font, but also the missing text. Text. Would this be sufficient then? Oh, this is not right. This should be like this. This run. And this is my last attempt. There you go. And you should see that this is the text, all the text up to galleries. Then you see the font size 11. Let's check that quickly. Font size 11. Font name Calibri. Font color is a black and there's no style on it. Let's make this a different style. Heading. Now let's rerun this. Now it says 16. Calibri light, font and a special color. And the body style is heading 1. Yay! That actually worked. Why is there still this link in here? I don't need a link in there. Yet. I should put this one in, I think. Where's the example that I used here? Not this one. This one, I think. Is it? No, this one is a selection. Let's put this one in. HTML. Get body text link. Quickly run it. Already running over 8 o'clock. Get body text link. That's this. Nice. Do this. And it worked. So, push this to Gist. Share. New public Gist. Oh no, I can update it because it's the current one. Update. Go to GitHub. And it's in. Revision 2. Yeah, deleted a lot of stuff and put some new stuff in there. So if you go to Bang Gist, you can find it on my GitHub page and play with it for yourself. So let's move back to the main screen. Would like to thank everyone for watching again this morning. It's quite early for me, somewhat late for most of you, I think. But that's always a pain of being on two continents. On the other hand, thank you also David for watching. And I will be back tomorrow at 6:45 Europe time. So that will be something, let me pull up the schedule, copy, and notepad, another notepad, schedule. Tomorrow I will be 6:45 Europe, and that's 12:45 Eastern time and 10:45 PM Pacific time. Hope to that I can see you all back tomorrow, and thanks for watching, and see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.